Boeing has now delivered the first of its ORCA extra-large unmanned undersea vehicles, or XLUUVs, to the U.S. Navy. The company stated in a tweet, "More than a decade of pioneering work went into developing ORCA, a new class of autonomous submarine that can perform long-duration critical missions in contested and changing waters. Delivery of the submarine drone has been delayed by several years, in part due to differences between ORCA and its prototype, as well as the onset of the COVID-19 pandemic. The delivery came after Boeing and the U.S. Navy conducted several phases of at-sea testing, including maneuvering above and below the surface." In this video, Defense Updates analyzes what ORCA XLUUV brings to the table for the U.S. Navy. Let's get into the details. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. The Pentagon has stated the ORCA XLUUV will be modular in construction, with the core vehicle providing guidance and control, navigation, autonomy, situational awareness, core communications, power distribution, energy and power, propulsion and maneuvering, and mission sensors. It will have well-defined interfaces for the potential of implementing cost-effective upgrades in future increments to leverage advances in technology and respond to threat changes. The service plans to use the ORCAs to explore and refine future concepts of operation for underwater drones of this size, which could include gathering intelligence, placing or clearing naval mines, attacking other ships or submarines, conducting standoff strikes, and more. There were two main competing parties, Lockheed Martin and Boeing. In October 2017, both companies received design phase awards. Lockheed's proposed design was a vessel that was shaped like an enlarged torpedo. Boeing's design is similar to a small submarine and is to a large extent derived from a previous private venture known as Echo Voyager, which is an unmanned diesel-electric submersible. Ultimately, the Navy preferred Boeing's design and hence it was given the contract. The contract was worth $43 million for 4 ORCAs in February 2019. A 5th ORCA was subsequently ordered in March of that year. ORCA is 80 tons and 85 feet long. Its primary components include guidance and control, navigation, autonomy, situational awareness, core communications, power distribution, propulsion and maneuvering, and mission sensors. A distinctive part of its design is the extendable mast, which can be raised when close to the surface and provides a number of functions including satellite connectivity. The vessel is thought to be powered by a hybrid diesel-lithium-ion battery system, which powers the ORCA by battery while submerged and recharges the batteries with diesel generators while surfaced. Maximum speed is 8 knots or 15 kilometers per hour, though the typical service speed is about 3 knots or 5.6 kilometers per hour, which gives the ORCA a range of up to 6,500 miles, which is 10,500 kilometers, with an endurance of several months. Within the ORCA aft section lies space for modular payloads. The 34-foot-long payload section is capable of supporting an 8-ton payload capacity and can be reconfigured for a range of mission sets. The U.S. Navy primarily plans to utilize this space to dispense mines, to start with. The service would eventually like to use this space to arm the ORCA with weapons like torpedoes. All in all, Boeing is set to deliver a further 4 ORCAs to the U.S. Navy, with the final examples slated to be handed over in June of 2024. These will ultimately work with traditional surface vessels, including unmanned ones like LRUSVs, large unmanned surface vehicles. Viewers may note that the U.S. has big plans for unmanned vessels. Officials have said the U.S. Navy's hybrid future fleet will be split between crewed and uncrewed vessels to provide both sensors and weapons capacity needed for the extended ranges required to operate under Distributed Maritime Operations, DMO. Captain Scott Searles, Program Manager for Unmanned Maritime Systems, said at Sea Airspace in April 2013, "By the middle of this century, up to 40% of the fleet will be unmanned. There's a clear demand signal to develop and field it, and it has to be affordable. That's the thing we've got to go key on now. When it's in this nascent stage of development, make it affordable, lethal, scalable, and connected." Given the elaborate goals, ORCA is positioned to play a key role in the U.S. Navy's future plans.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.